have in this room? Millionaires? Millionaires? Okay. If you haven't thought of becoming a millionaire, you better think about it today. Okay. My name is Thandi. I love speaking to VIPs like you. The CEO has said it right that you are very, very important guests today. Actually, very, very important people today. So as I'm standing here, I'm privileged to be speaking to very important people like you. Okay. Yesterday's audience was very intriguing. I've listened to many of learners that were seated there, and many of them were asking very powerful questions. Questions of, you know, that were making sense to me as a business person. They were asking questions about, you know, how do they move forward with the proposals that they had. And I realized that, you know what, as much as we think you are learners seated there, you've got ideas of how to start your own businesses. And today, when I finish, you know, talking to you, I want you to start thinking of that particular thing that's gonna make you a business person. Are we all agreeing to that?
Yes.
Yeah? Yes. But you don't sound enthusiastic. Are we all agreeing?
Yes.
Are we all agreeing?
Yes.
Okay, now I'm going to start it all over again. How many millionaires are in this room?
Yes.
Yes.
You know, it was very interesting yesterday. The minister said when she's standing here at the podium, looking at all of you, she saw future, the future of South Africa. You are future millionaires. I want to share something with you. When I went through the FP&M website, particularly about this event, this is the statement that captured me, okay? You definitely have the space in the growth of the economy of South Africa. And I want you to start thinking about it, because this to me was a capture. Why? Because when you look at the top 27 richest people in South Africa, we're only going to speak South Africa because we South Africans, proudly South Africans. Top 27 richest people in South Africa, none of the people there are young, okay? Look at it. But we're very privileged that we've got our president, Cyril Ramaphosa, amongst the top 27 of the richest people in South Africa. And we've had the deputy minister today talking to us about the investment summit that the president had. It's to grow the economy of South Africa, and that is where you come in. Because you are the future. Are we okay? You better listen very carefully, because when we finish here, I'm going to ask you questions. Are you commenting to the slide? Do you want to talk to me about it? Or not now? Now, we're gonna talk about it. I want to hear that. But look at this. We've got the top 10 young South African millionaires. This is so inspiring. And I see many of you seated there who are going to be on this list. Do you agree with me? Do you want to be on that list? Are you sure? Okay. We're going to talk about the first three. Let's talk about this first three. Sandile Shesi, one of the millionaires. He started when he was still at school. He is 27 years old. He used to sell muffins at school. They used to laugh at him. You know why he sold muffins? Because he was trying to save some money to go to tertiary, to go and study. But he realized that there are better opportunities for him. He started trading. He started trading. We've got Ludwig Marishali. Ludwig is the founder of Dry Bath. His idea was inspired by a friend who never liked bathing. while he was lying there, lazy to bath, he made a comment and said, hey, I wish there could be something that, you know, we just rub on the body and you are clean. That inspired him. He started something. We've got Rupert Bryant at 10. He loved internet. How many of you go to internet? Yeah? You do. He became very passionate about it. And he started designing websites. He designed websites at 10. At 14, he started his own thing. At 16, a friend said, I want to do it with you. Today, they are a company. It's a multi-millionaire company worth 130,000. All these people started when they are in school, okay? Then we've got the ladies. Khumalemo Munya. She loves wigs. How many of you love doing hair, ladies? She saw an opportunity by something that she liked. People were asking her, where did you do your hair? What did you do? She saw a gap there. That's where she identified where she can make money. We've got Tato and Kanye. Tato, Kanye, and Ria. These two, they inspire me big time. They are childhood friends. Both of them decided, they registered the company because they knew they wanted to do something. They knew they wanted to own businesses. But then later, as they were sitting, they decided they're going to make school bags, okay? From plastic bags, recycled. And the school bags, what can school bags do? At night, they give light so that you can study. Can you see it's innovation? Yeah? So now, when you leave here, I want you to start having a business mind. Have a business mind. What is a business mind? A business mind is created by what you believe you can do. I believe many of you who are seated here, you know what you can do best. Am I right? Okay? You must start embracing it. What you can do best or differently from how others are doing it, or creating something from scratch that doesn't exist and put it together to create an opportunity to make a profit. And that's how you're going to become a millionaire, right? Establish a possible or successful business. So what you can do is the skill that you have. We've had many of the people that stood on this stage talking about skill. Having a skill is very important. You can't be a business person when you don't have a skill. Am I right? Best is when you get an experience. The more you do it, you gain experience, and you end up doing it to your level best. Am I right? Differently is when you become innovative. When you do something different, you don't do something that another person is doing. Do something from your own thinking or try to improve it in order for you to be different from what the other person is doing. You agree with me?
Yes.
Starting something from scratch. We all have ideas. Just be creative. Creativity is a process of thinking. So when you start becoming creative, you come up with ideas and you start putting something together. Yeah? Putting something together is coming up with a concept. When you have a concept, it's something that you can put down a proposal. When you put out a proposal, you're going to go and sell it somewhere, and somebody might buy it. Yeah? Then you create an opportunity to make a profit, and that's when you become a business person. But then you must always follow your passion, because success will follow you when you have passion. Okay? I don't want to, because I'm standing in front of very important people, I'm not going to be asked questions, but I'd rather want to ask you questions. Are you ready for the questions?
Yes.
Are you sure you're ready for the questions?
Yes.
Okay, let me start from this side. Why are you here? Just one person from this side. Why are you here today?
Today I'm here to learn about my future anymore. No more.
getting here today. I see two heads. We'll take the two. Yes.
Sambonani. Yabona base singusuka la manje yo advisor laba abanye ngibatshele ukuthi sifundini ngapha yini nje abasifundise yona about our passion into esifuna ukuzenza to start our own businesses abanye we want to create with the temperature.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Helen Mabane from Temsa High School. For me, a passion is something that doesn't make you sleep. You are always thinking about it. Every day, every second, everything you do, you put to it. It's your passion. You don't sleep. You work on it until you get there, until you become that quadrillionaire.
Yes.
That's the
question.
Thank you.
I love it. Okay. Do we move to the next question? The last one. And this one, I want you to think about it. And when you leave this place, you must actually act on it. Okay? I'm challenging you to do that. The last question is, what have you done in a group of friends that have made a difference or contributed positively in your community or at school?
Over here.
Greetings again. I'm Thandi Momubaghan from Timbisa Secondary School. Well, what I've done to do something different, I would be more specifically in my school.
Yeah.
We have an organization called Peers Empowerment. This organization basically deals with events management. We saw an opportunity that we as learners, we are capable of something and
yes,
we can do something.
Yes.
So what we basically do, we do school funds. We are the ones who try and organize funds because you can't always rely on the government.
Yes.
There are many schools in South Africa. So you basically do events in order to get something in return, and then at the beginning of the year, we try to donate something back towards the learners.
Well done!
So that's what you basically do.
Well done, well done. And I think many of you would learn from her. Okay, let it not be just an outing for you guys. Seated here and, you know, having fun with other friends and meeting other people. Utilize this opportunity to gain as much information as possible and become the best of you. Okay? Hello? Thank you so much. Hope to see you soon. Okay?